to all of you on the V Plus U Academy channel. My name is Ashish Garg, and today we will be going to discuss the MPPSC exam held on the 3rd of July 2022. So the purpose of this video is to tell you what are the questions whose answers are given wrong in the commission's answer key. So we will discuss those questions, and the whole motive of this video is to tell you, you can challenge these questions, and on the basis of if you challenge this question, you may get extra added or bonus marks in the exam. So basically, if we see MPPSC technical exam paper, in which 100 question is being asked from the technical paper, so out of those 100 question, I can see there are at least 5 questions which can be challenged easily. We will discuss those question one by one. So let's start with those question. But before that, I want to tell you that if you are scoring marks 290 or 230, that is a good score. 290, 230 marks in 290, 300 marks is a good score in MPPSC AE exam. MPPSC AE exam. So don't get disheartened if you are getting marks less than this. So the purpose is to, you have to challenge some of the questions, and maybe you get to select in the interview at least. So we will discuss those questions. I have the question paper of this year held on the 3rd of July 2022. So I will be discussing those questions which has been mainly technical questions which can be challenged. Starting from the, I have this set A. You can have any another set also, but the overall aim is to tell you what are the questions that can be challenged. So in the set A, first question is, which can be challenged is, we have 60th question. Methemoglobinemia in children. Methemoglobinemia disease is caused by. This is the question asked, and there are 4 options. Among them, the answer that is given by the commission is, the conversion of nitrates to nitrites is the reason behind the methemoglobinemia disease. I think this is a correct answer that is given by the commission also. Actually, lot of people are saying that the answer should be conversion of nitrites to nitrates. I think which is absolutely wrong, because we know that the nitrites has a permissible limit of 0 mg/L. 0 mg/L. There is a reason behind we have this permissible limit, while nitrates has a permissible limit of 45 mg/L. 45 mg/L as per code 10500/2012. So methemoglobinemia disease actually caused by nitrates, but it is actually formed from the nitrites. Nitrites is the main reason which is responsible for this disease, unlike nitrates. So this is a correct answer. Answer should be conversion of nitrates to nitrites, which cause the methemoglobinemia disease. So this solves our one of the problems which has some disputes. The next question is related to the train resistance due to gradient is given as. This is a question asked. Train resistance due to gradient. We have to calculate the train resistance due to gradient, or formula batana tha wahan pe hame. What is the train resistance due to gradient? It's simple, direct formula should be. Answer A. What is that? That is a weight of train into the rate of grade. But the commission give its answer B. That is weight of train into 1 by rate of grade. So these questions can be challenged. This question can be challenged. You can take a contest of any book. You can take any book and you can take a screenshot, or you can take a pic of that book and you can upload in the commission's website, whatever they are giving a portal for your challenge. So this question can also be challenged. This question can be challenged. Now the third question. There is the stress in a cement concrete pavement changes, and the options are seasonally, annually, or daily, or none of the above. So the answer should be, what should be the answer? If we actually analyze this question, they are saying the stress in the cement concrete pavement. Stress in cement concrete pavement changes. Why the stress in cement concrete pavement changes? We know that we have three stresses mainly in the cement concrete pavement, or general analysis के लिए हमें तीन stresses होते हैं. What are those? Those are our wheel load, warping load and the frictional load, or same as you can say these as also stresses, load or stresses. So we know that the wheel load is acting every time. Whenever the vehicle is moving, there is a wheel load. But the warping loads or the frictional loads, warping load acts on a daily basis. It's act on a daily basis, while frictional load acts on a seasonal basis. So how we should answer this? The stress in a cement concrete pavement changes. It changes seasonally as well. It changes annually as well. It changes daily as well. So the answer should be, cannot be said that it should be daily, seasonally or annually. The most appropriate answer should be here, it should be daily, because we can see that if we are seeing that the stresses are changing daily, then that means also it will be changing seasonally and it will be changing also due to wheel loads. So the most appropriate answer should be here, daily, which the commission has given as a seasonally. So this question also can be challenged. This is our question number 76 in set A. So this is one more question which can be challenged. Now some people are saying in the 93rd question, where there is asked a net area of angle in a gusset plate. The diagram is something like that. This is a diagram. Here is a bolt. You have to tell the effective area of this plate. So the answer should be, you have to subtract this area, and your answer should be this. Some people have done actually net area, they have taken a1 plus ka2, which is actually wrong. You have to tell only a1 plus a2. This is the net area. So I hope you understand what I am actually saying here. So we will be going to next question. The next question which can be claimed is the width of the blast. Width of the blast section at the bottom of the track for broad gauge. This is the question being asked, and its options are 4200, 4600, 4800 and the 5000. Commission ne aapko answer diya hai 4800. But actually this can also be challenged. In some books this is written as 4200, in some also there are 3800. So these questions can be challenged. So this is our third question which can be challenged. We have already 1, 2, 3. This is third question which can also be challenged. Now moving to the question which also has the probability of being challenged is, now one of the question is related to this. For ductile material, the most appropriate failure theory is, ductile material ke liye appropriate theory kya hai? We know that all the theories are applicable for ductile material except maximum principal stress theory. So we can say here we have three more options on which we can say that this theory is applicable. But the most appropriate should be shear strain energy theory or maximum distortion energy theory, But the answer here in the commission's answer key is given as the maximum shear stress theory. So that question can also be challenged. This is our fourth question. This can also be challenged. Now one more question is related to the development length, in which the question is being asked is the development length of a deformed bar. It is written as development length of a deformed bar as per IS 456-2000 in limit state design is given by. We have four options, but none of the options is matching our given answer. The what should be the development length? It should be 0.87 f/5 into 4 into 1.6 tau bd. 1.6 tau bd. Why 1.6? Because it is given that the bar is a deformed bar. So we have to increase it by 60% to cater for the deformed bar nature. So there is none of the option is given. So this question also should be removed from the paper. So this is our fifth question. This is our fifth question. These are the five questions can be challenged, which can be challenged. Now I think these are the some of the questions which can be challenged, unless all our other questions are can be done or the answer key is right most probably. But if you have any doubt related to any other questions, then you can comment on the comment below this video, and I will definitely reply on that video. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.